I'm Heather Stapleton. I'm an environmental chemist and exposure scientist. My research program focuses on identifying man-made chemicals in consumer products and construction materials that are often applied to the indoor environment. And understanding where they're used and how they're used is often very challenging in the field of environmental health and environmental science. We're really interested in understanding and connecting the dots between chemicals and products, exposure among the general population, and whether there are or are not any health risks from that exposure. We're one of the few labs in the country that have the capacity to measure or detect a large suite of different flame retardant chemicals used in consumer products and construction materials. We've been conducting research in this field for more than 10 years now, and from our previous research, we do know that children have a disproportionate amount of the exposure compared to adults for specific classes of flame retardants. Research has suggested that exposure to flame retardants, and in particular PBDEs, is associated with deficits in neural development, particularly in children, which translates to deficits in cognitive function, IQ, sometimes associated with hyperactivity. It's also been associated with alterations in circulating levels of thyroid hormones. Recently, our research group collaborated with doctors in the Duke Cancer Center to examine exposures to flame retardants in individuals recently diagnosed with papillary thyroid cancer and compared their exposures to individuals that were cancer-free but of similar demographics. And we found that exposure to several flame retardant chemicals was significantly higher in the individuals that were diagnosed with papillary thyroid cancer. Identifying what these chemicals are in these consumer products can be very challenging for the general public because they're not disclosed on the product or the labeling. Therefore, we've considered our laboratory to be almost an environmental CSI. We bring products into the lab, analyze them by mass spectrometry to identify the chemical structures. So now if there are individuals in the general public that are concerned about these chemicals and want to understand or determine if these chemicals might be present in the product in their home, they can actually take a small piece of it and actually mail it to us, and we can analyze it free of charge and report back to them on whether these chemicals were present or absent. One of the things I am most proud of is the research we conducted on flame retardant chemicals in baby products. A government agency, in this case the state of California, used that data to exempt several baby products, including nursing pillows, baby carriers, baby strollers, so that manufacturers no longer have to use those chemicals in those products, which does lead to reductions in exposure.